AI tools like ChatGPT, have become a part of our daily life. These tools were developed with large language models like OpenAI GPT-4 and Google Palm. Good news! A tool called LangChain was developed to work with LLMs. Using this tool, you can build end-to-end language model applications. This video will give you a quick walkthrough on how to use LangChain. Let's jump into the Collab Notebook and unlock LangChain step by step. To use LangChain, let's first install it with the pip command. Let's write pip install q LangChain. The q flag is used to suppress the output during the installation process. To work with LangChain, you need integrations with one or more model providers, such as OpenAI or Hugging Face. For this example, we'll be leveraging OpenAI's APIs, so we'll need to install it first. Let's write pip install q OpenAI. After installing OpenAI, we need to set the environment variable. To do this, let's use the OS module. Let's write import OS. Next, let's set OpenAI API key with the environ method. OS environ OpenAI API key. Next, let's write your API key. I just set this variable. Note that, to get OpenAI API key, go to the OpenAI website, click the menu, and then view API keys. You can see your API keys here. If you want, you can create a new API key. Cool. We set our environment variable. Let's move on to building a language model application. In this section, we'll see how to get predictions from a language model. LangChain has many modules that can be used to create language model applications. Large language models are a core component of LangChain. Note that LangChain is not an LLMs provider, but instead allows you to work with various LLMs. Now, let's get an LLM like OpenAI and predict with this model. Let's write from LangChain LLMS import OpenAI. Next, let's initialize the wrapper with the temperature parameter. This parameter sets randomness. Let's set LLM OpenAI temperature 0.7. Now, let's get a text and predict this text with this LLM. Let's say text, what are the 5 most expensive capital cities? Let's get a prediction from our language model. Let's write LLM text. Here you go. As you can see, our model made a prediction. Cool. If you want, you can use a specific model in OpenAI. Let me show this. Let's say LLM1 OpenAI model name GPT 3.5 Turbo. Let's generate a text with this model. Let's set print. Let's pass LLM1 and then tell me a joke. Here you go. In the previous example, we sent user input directly to the LLM. But, when using an LLM in an application, you usually take user input and construct a prompt. This is a piece of cake to perform with LangChain. Let's first define the prompt template. Let's write from LangChain prompts import prompt template. After that, let me create the prompt. Let's say prompt prompt template. And let's pass input variables. And let's set input. After that, template, and let's say which are the 5 most. Let's write input capital cities. Okay, we create our prompt. To get a prediction, let's now call the format method and pass it as input. Let's write print, let's pass prompt format, and then input popular. Here, you can see our prompt. Let's move on to combining LLMs and prompts in multi-step workflows. So far, we've seen how to instance an LLM model, and then we've used it to get a prediction with this model. We can also combine these steps. In this section, we're going to learn how to chain multiple steps. To show this, let's import the LLM chain class. Let's say from LangChain chains import LLM chain. Next, let's instance an LLM again. Let's say LLM OpenAI, let's set temperature 0.7. After that, let's create a prompt. Let's write prompt prompt template input variables. Let's give country. After that, template. Where is the capital of country? Awesome, we've had a prompt and a model. Now, let's create an LLM chain. Let's say chain LLM chain LLM equals LLM and then prompt prompt. Now, let's use the run method and pass it to the USA. Let's write print and then let's pass chain run, let's give USA. Here you go. Note that this is one of the simplest kinds of chains. Let's move on to creating more complex chains. To combine chains, let's create agents. Agents allow you to specify the order of action types. It is very crucial to use the correct agents to make good predictions. To show this, let's first instance an LLM. Let's say, LLM, OpenAI. Let's set temperature and 0. Next, let's load some tools to use. Let me import the load tools method. Let's write from langchain agents import load tools. Now, let's set the APIs we're going to use. We're going to leverage Google Search API. First, let's install this API. Let's say pip install q Google Search results. Next, let's set the API key. You can find this API key for free on the Google Search API website. Let's set OS environ serpapiapyke your API key. Next, let's load some tools to use. Let's write tools load tools. Let's pass serp ap and then llm math llm equals llm. What we're going to do is initialize an agent with the tools with the initialize agent method. Let me import this method first. Let's write from langchain agents import initialize agent. Next, let's import agent type to set the agent parameter. Let's write from langchain agents import agent type. Cool. We've imported our methods. Let's go one step further and create an agent. Let's write agent initialize agent. Let's give tools LLM and then agent agent type. Let's set 0-shot react description and then verbose. Let's set true. Okay, we've had an agent. Let's test it now. Let's write agent run. Let's say who is the director of the Walking Dead series and then what is his current age raised to the 0.35 power. As you can see, our agent dynamically carried out chains based on our input. The agent we just created found the director of the Walking Dead series and then it calculated the 0.35 power of his age. Cool. In this video, we covered LangChain and unleashed its power with a few simple examples. We'll make new videos to explore LangChain in depth. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss new videos. You can find the link to the notebook I used in the description below. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy it. If you have any questions, let me know. Follow us on other social platforms. The links are below. See you in the next video. Bye for now.